One of the most loved songs is a song that I actually collaborated with Mamamoo called Aup. But it's also one of the most painful memories I have in the music industry. And I never really had a chance to talk about that song and all the shit that went on and the behind the scenes stuff. But I guess I'll talk about it a little bit now. So basically, I wrote this song because an A&R had given me a track and was like, this song is for Ihai. This track is for Ihai, or we're trying to pitch it. And I was like, okay, let me take a stab at it. And so people who write the melody line over a track that is given to you are called topliners. So I was toplining on this track. So I wrote it, and the track was, oh, it was something that I would want to sing, you know, and I was grooving, and I wrote this sick-ass melody, like amazing lyrics, and I was like, fuck, I can't believe I wrote a song like that. And then, you know, I was signed to the company, so I had to get permission, and I showed it to my producer, and I was like, this is what I wrote, and they're like, don't give this song to anyone. This has you written all over it. This is you. This is your style. This is all you. If you give that away, you're basically giving away your identity as a singer. And I was like, oh, that's not good. So I told the A&R, I can't give you the top line. Like, I can try writing another one, but I can't give you the one that I have right now. And so what ended up happening is Ihai didn't even use the track at all. And so I was informed that they weren't going to use it. And so then maybe like a year later, I contacted that A&R again and I said, can we buy that track from you so that... Because the melody, I mean, we can always make a new track to the melody that I have, but it was just such a perfect match with that track. And basically he said, the writer doesn't want to sell it, you know? And I was like, okay, well, I don't know what I'm going to do with this melody then, because I have to get it out, but I don't know what to do. And so I talked to my producer and I said, why don't we just save this and rearrange it, reproduce, you know, a track for it, and it'll be my debut song for TV. For TV broadcast. So I had officially debuted, you know, so I'm a singer, but my official like debut on, you know, the weekend shows that we have in Korea, which is basically how singers promote their music. So every day of the week, there is a music program where idols will go on the show and promote the songs that they just released. And so this song was supposed to be that song for me. We had kept it safe for like 2 years. And I still remember I was taking a nap at home and all of a sudden the producer calls me and is like, hey, I got an idea. How about you collaborate that song with Mamamoo? And my initial reaction was like, no, this is my song. Like, I'm supposed to debut on TV with this song. And so initially I was like, oh, I mean, you're like an amazing writer. I'm a writer. Like, why can't we just write a new song that we can both sing? And he was like, no, like, I think we should do this song. And I kind of got cornered into it because he was like, I was like, what if I don't want to do it? And he's like, well, then we're going to just have to think about how other ways that we're going to have to promote you. And it had been a while since I released my last album. And I was like so hungry to just get something out. And Mamamoo was like slowly on the incline. They hadn't gotten to a point where they were like full blown stars yet, but they were well on their way, you know, because they were packaged really well. And, you know, they all have immense talent and I knew they were going to make it. So I was like, okay, again, let me just put myself aside and let's do this. Cause it's still me doing the music. Like, we're still doing it together. But man, that whole process was so stressful because the song I'm supposed to sing by myself, now I had to divvy the part for all five of us, you know? And, you know, they're strong characters too. They got personalities. And so they would want to be like, I want to sing this part and I want to sing that part. And like, just, it would every time, like, it would just tear me apart because I was supposed to sing the song, you know? But in the end, it got done. And the torture of it all was also, I had to make them sound good because I directed them in the studio from beginning to end. Did all the background vocals for it and all that. And so it was very stressful for me. And now we're getting ready to be on TV and these girls are like, you know, very skinny, typical idol looking girls. And like, here I am, like this thick girl, you know, and 비교가 돼. Like we get compared, it, you know, and you know, the way that they wanted to package us was I'm this like musician. And so he had me in like a white suit and like they had like these funky outfits. And so I don't care how old you are, you in a suit, you're going to look older. You know what I mean? And so visually, I looked older than them. And the craziest thing was, I was told that I had to hit a certain number if I wanted to go on TV and promote that song. And this was like a few days before we started on Thursday, which is M Countdown. And so I was like, I mean, this goes against everything that I stand for, but if this is what I need to do, like I need to hit the number to promote my own song, fuck, then I got to do it. And so I remember like not eating for a few days. And then the day before I had to weigh in, didn't drink water. And I took a laxative the day before so that I just like shat everything out. And luckily I hit that number. But obviously as soon as I ate something, like it like shot back up because literally you're just losing water weight, right? But anyway, so I did that. And come the day the music gets released and it is our first day of promotions, we're all in our van heading towards M Countdown. And the song gets released. And I check. Everyone checks. We check. And my name's not on there. It just says Mamamoo on there. And look, already, you know, this whole process about this song was very stressful for me. But then seeing that, like, it just, my insides got cold. Because I was just like, why isn't my name on there? Because that's not a, I don't know who made the mistake, but I'm betting the company made the mistake when they passed over the, all the information, you know? Or maybe it was distributors, you know, mistake for leaving out my name. I don't know what the fuck the reason was. Whatever it was wrong, you know? And then I remember I texted my producer and I was like, my name's not on there. And he was like, oh, we'll fix it right away. We're on it. We're fixing it right away. It's like, okay, fine, whatever. So we go, get to the green room. And usually when you get to the green room, all the artist names are on whatever room you're using or whatever stall you're using, right? I get there, only Mamamoo's name is on there. And I'm like, what the fuck is this? Like, I thought this is supposed to be a collaboration, okay? It's not even a featuring. That's different. It's a collaboration and it's my fucking song. Why is my name not on the fucking dressing room? And so all these tiny little things are starting to just like eat away at me on the first day of fucking promotions. And I am in such a horrible mood. And if you see any of the footage of like me and Mamamoo backstage, like whatever, like I'm just trying really hard to put on a smile. Because again, everything is just geared towards them. And I'm like, I don't get it. Like, what am I doing here? You know? And I didn't like how my outfit fit, whatever. And like, so we do the show. And I believe right away when the show was done, we went back to the office to keep practicing. And then I get called in by the producer. And he sits me down and he's like, we read all of the comments that people have been leaving on the videos and all that. And, you know, they're not very good about you. And I was like, what are they saying? They're like, oh, they're saying you look old, you know, and they're saying that they're just attacking you like image wise or whatever. They're just negative comments about you. And I said, I don't care about the image ones. That's not, you know, if you don't like the way I look, then I don't give a fuck what you think, you know. But if you're saying things about my music, then I'll take offense to it. And there were comments like, why does Esna have such a big part in the song? Mamamoo can do this song without Esna. Why is she even there? And just, you know, more and more of that kind of comments. And I was like, that's what really hurt me. And so in the end, when he sat me down, he said, I think it's best if we stop you from going out on the rest of the TV promotions and just have Mamamoo do the rest of the and it was only a 2-week promotion. And I just remember, again, you guys might not believe me, but I really don't cry a lot. But like, I, you know, it was one of those like silent, just like, you know, because 말문이 막히잖아. Like I was speechless. And I was like, I don't think it's the right move. I don't care what the 댓글 or the comments say. The company should stand by your artist. Because if you take me off, you're basically agreeing with those fuckers out there that are saying your artist looks like shit, your artist looks old, your artist shouldn't be a part of this song. You're basically agreeing with them. And they were like, it's our final decision and we're just going to have Mamamoo promote the rest of it. And so I, with that information in mind, I still had 2 more shows, right? So I had Friday and Saturday and I go and I do it. And after every show is over, the singers, you know, wait and in front of the PD Neem's office, the TV producer's office, to go and like say, thank you for having us on the show. And like, 인사하러 we go. But when we went to those, to go 인사 to the PD Neem's, he wouldn't introduce me. He would only introduce Mamamoo. And I'm like, what is this? Like, what am I doing right now? You know, like just little things like that kept eating away at me. And then, and this is after the fact that I heard I only have 2 shows left out of a 2-week promotion. And it just, it really boiled me so much that I was just so like, all right, let me just get through the motion and do this. And the crazier thing is the people at the TV stations, you know, are told ahead of time who is going to be on the show, and then they do the set design, right? And so they basically told me like on Saturday, today's going to be your last one. And I was like, okay, that's fine, whatever. And so I'm thinking, what are they going to do about the set if they have to like change it super fast, you know? And then so I monitored Sunday, Inki Gayo, and they were like, because this is literally what they said. They said, Inki Gayo has the most viewers out of all of the shows. So we're going to have you stop on Saturday on Music Core before Sunday. That's literally what they told me. So then I watched the show. But the set design only says Mamamoo on it. And I'm like, you guys fixed that set design that quick, like in a day? It just didn't make any sense. I may be wrong. I may be completely wrong, but it just didn't make any sense that a whole set design changed only for them if they had been informed that I would be on that stage with them. So the song was very, it's a painful song. I love this song, but it's a painful song. And so I was like, I can't just not respond to any of this. This is stupid. Like I can't have people chip away, especially I felt like it was my company that was not having my back. And so then I made, I guess, a diss track, or I, you know, made a remake of Aup, and I wrote a song called Ah Shit. And I posted that on YouTube, and there's not one person. There's like a lot of comments on there. They're not one person say bad thing to me. You know what I mean? Like, I think it was the first time in Korea that an artist put the netizens in their place and was like, shut the fuck up. What do you know? And this is the first time that I'm going really in depth with this song. I feel like a lot of people are going to have a lot of things to say. So I'm a little worried about it. But, you know, it's the truth. What can you do? You know, and now a lot of people will know the truth about this song. And so then when I made my mini album, the song with Me Today as a title, I told my producer, I was like, I need to do a solo version of this song by myself on my album. I need it. I need it. And he was like, why? Like, why? You know, and I was like, just, I need it. So it's there. Just the Esna version, it says in parentheses, it's there. And yeah, it was just so weird. Like, you know, if, okay, fine, don't put me on the TV shows, but they promoted, did a lot of events, which they were getting paid for, singing the song. I'm like, if did radio shows, things like that. I'm like, I should have been a part of all the rest of the schedule. if not the TV stuff, because you think I'm, you know, ruining. Because honestly, I think they were more worried about Mamamoo's image being hurt than me, which is why they took me. Like, that's, yeah, it's, I, till this day, that's kind of what I believe. And that's what I felt. And ever since then is when the relationship between me and my company started getting a little weird. And I didn't feel as at home with that company. And, you know, which is why I actually ended my contract early and left before it was over. But we both agreed, you know, they're like, oh, I think we should let you go. And I was like, yeah, I think I should leave. Like, we just, I don't think anyone has ever also left their company and their contract as easily as I did. So yeah, that was a very difficult time for me.